Hello learners, welcome to our studio of National Institute of Open Schooling. I am Arvind Singh Negi, your maths teacher. Friends, if we talk about English alphabets, we know that we are having 26 alphabets. And out of these 26 alphabets, we have 5 vowels and 21 consonants. If we want to find the collection of consonants, we know that we are having 26 consonants, and also we are sure that which alphabet we are going to include and which alphabet is not to be included. The collection about which we are sure that which item is to be included and which is to be not is a set. So, if you want to write the definition of a set is a collection of well-defined objects. Friends, the meaning of well-defined here is a given collection of objects is said to be well-defined if we can definitely say whether a given particular object belongs to the set or not. For example, collection of vowels of English alphabet. A, E, I, O, U. Friends, we all know that we are having only 5 vowels in the English alphabet, which are A, E, I, O, U. No other alphabet can be included in this collection. So, it is a set. Let's take one more example. Collection of even natural numbers less than 10. Friends, we know that even numbers are divisible by 2. And here the condition is natural number less than 10. So this collection will include 2, 4, 6, and 8. No other element can be included in this. So this will also be a set. The objects in a set are called its elements or members. So the elements which we are going to include in a set are also called its members. Generally, a set is denoted by capital letters. So, generally, we use capital A, capital B, capital X, Y, Z, etc. to denote a set. One more important point is, repeating elements are included once only in the set. It means that if the given number of items that we are having, if any number is repeating in that, we are going to include it once only. So friends, let's take few more examples which will make the meaning of set more clear to us. Collection of intelligent students of your class. Now friends, we know that intelligent is not defined. It is not a well-defined term. Why it is not well-defined? Because according to maths teacher, the group of intelligent students will be something, but according to English teacher, the group of intelligent students will be something else. According to social science teacher, the collection of intelligent students may be different. So the term intelligent here is not well defined. And if we take this example in this way, collection of students of your class who have secured more than 80% marks in annual examination. What we are finding here, friends, in this example, we are given with the students, those who have secured more than 80% marks. Now, 80% is a well-defined. If you talk about the English teacher, according to the English teacher, the students getting 80% marks or the more than 80% marks will be some students. If you talk about maths teacher, the students securing more than 80% marks will be same, and the collection of the students will be same according to social science teacher also. So 80% is well defined here. Let's take one more example. Collection of interesting books in your school library. Now again, interesting is not well defined because it may differ from person to person. But if we talk about the collection of maths books in your library, that will be well defined. because we know here that which book we are going to include and which book is not to be included. So, the collection of interesting books will not form a set, while the collection of maths books will form a set here. Now, if we talk about the collection of tall students in your school, that will again not form a set because we are not given the measurement of the height. It is just said tall students. So, since it is not a well-defined collection, it will also not form a set. But if we talk about the students of your school whose height is more than 180 centimeter, it will form a set. So, friends, let's now talk about some standard sets. Capital N. The symbol capital N is generally used to denote the set of natural numbers. Natural numbers, we all know that natural numbers are the counting numbers 1, 2, 3, 4 and so on. W, set of whole numbers. Whole numbers include 0 also and the natural numbers 0, 1, 2, 3, 4 and so on. Next is Z or I. It is used to represent the set of integers. Integers are the positive numbers as well as the negative numbers, but not in decimal form, like 1, 2, 3, 4 and so on, which includes 0 also, and the negative numbers of these, minus 1, minus 2, minus 3, it will go up to minus infinity. The next set that we are having, Z positive. Z positive means all the positive integers, which include 0 also. Z negative, set of negative integers. Friends, the set of negative integers start from minus 1, then minus 2, minus 3, and it goes up to minus infinity. Q, set of rational numbers. R, set of real numbers. C is used to denote the set of complex numbers. And some frequently used symbols in the set theory are belongs to, not belongs to, there exist, there does not exist. Friends, later on while doing some problems, we will be using these symbols frequently. The meaning of these symbols will be clear to you in those problems. Let's now talk about the representation of set. Generally, friends, we are having two methods to represent a set. First method is roster form or tabular form. In this method, a set is represented by listing all its elements, separating the elements by commas, and enclosing them in curly brackets. So, what we need to do here, we just write the collection of the elements or the set members, separating them with the help of commas, and we enclose the collection within curly brackets. For example, set of vowels of English alphabets. Friends, we know that we are having 5 vowels, A, E, I, O, U. If we separate these vowels using commas and we enclose those vowels within curly brackets, that will form a set. And such type of representation will be roster form, or which is also known as tabular form. Let us take one more example. If A be the set of natural numbers less than 7, if we take the set of natural numbers less than 7, then friends, we will have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6. 7 is not to be included because we are taking the numbers less than 7. So, writing these 6 numbers by separating the numbers with the help of commas and enclosing the numbers into curly brackets will be the roster form of this set. To write a set in roster form, elements are not to be repeated. Whenever, friends, we are writing a set into roster form, we may have the elements which are repeating, but when we are going to write the set, we include the numbers once only. For example, If A be the set of letters of the word mathematics, then the roster form of it will be M A T H E I C S. What we are observing here, friends, the letter M is repeating, T is also repeating, and the letter A is also repeating two times. But when we write the roster form of it, we are going to take these letters once only. The second method to represent a set is set builder form. In this form, elements of the set are not listed but are represented by some common property. It means for using this form, which is set builder form, the elements should follow some common property. Then only we can use this method. For example, let A be the set of natural numbers less than 7. Then set builder form of this set will be A equal to x such that x belongs to natural number and x is greater than or equal to 1 and less than 7. What we are observing here is all the elements of the set are following a common property. The common property here is all the numbers are natural numbers and all are less than 7. For representing this, we have written the set equal to x, and after that we defined this x. This x is a number which belongs to natural number. This x is greater than or equal to 1 but less than 7. So all the natural numbers which follow this criteria will be included in this set. So friends, today we studied about the meaning of sets, the representations of sets, types of sets, and the operations applicable to the sets. So this was all about sets, friends. For queries, you can log on to our website, which is www.nios.ac.in. Thank you and have a nice day. Keep on watching us.